Hi guys, Tom Quayle here, back for Guitar Interactive magazine with another review. Hope you're all doing very well. Today, I'm checking out this beast of a product. This is the Boss Waza Tube Amp Expander. And this thing is blowing minds left, right and center through the industry. It's really, really amazing. It's effectively a very high-end variable reactive load box and attenuator, as well as being an incredible recording tool and live tool that features basically speaker emulation, incredible quality effects, amazing I/O capabilities in terms of recording and again live use, and just a ton of different features that make it an all-in-one box for live and recording use with tube amps that essentially takes your tube amp and makes it this incredibly versatile versatile tool for live and studio use. It's really, really amazing. So the way we've got this hooked up today, I'll go through exactly what it does in a second because it's a bit of a complicated product that requires a bit of explanation, but the way we've got this hooked up today is I'm using this incredible Victory Super Kraken amplifier. It's a 100 watt head. We've got this plugged into, via the speaker out, into the Waza Tube Amp Expander. And then you're hearing throughout the video a couple of different things. You're hearing this going to an orange 2x12 cab that's mic'd up in our live room. But you're also at certain points going to be hearing the DI outs of this unit using the speaker emulation on board and the effects on board. So one thing I should say is any effects, reverbs, delays, compression, or even any modulation effects are all going to be coming from the Waza Tube Amp Expander. We're not using any kind of delays or reverbs on the floor here at all. And any speaker simulation you're going to hear as well is coming from the Tube Amp Expander. It's an amazing product. So let's go through what this unit does in detail. There's a lot of stuff here, guys, so a fair bit of talking, but I'll try and play as much as possible. So the first application of this unit is basically as an attenuator. We all know the problem that you run into with really loud tube amps like this. This 100 watt head here needs to be at a certain volume level before those power tubes kick in and give us that classic tube amp saturation and dynamics and clarity that we all know and love, that warmth of tone and response. Now this amp, 100 watts, this master volume here, it doesn't look like it's cranked, but actually if we were to be in the room with this, with say the 2x12 that we're using or a 4x12, it is insanely loud. Most tube amps get up to about halfway with the volume, and then as you keep going, you don't get any more volume, you just get more power tube saturation, that thing that we love basically. So this is insanely loud in the room. Now what an attenuator does is it takes that sound from the, or the signal from the power amp out, or the speaker out from your amplifier, and we run into the Waza Tube Amp Expander, and we can run that same signal and dissipate a lot of the energy, but basically turn the volume of the amplifier down without affecting the gain structure and kind of feel and response characteristics of our particular amplifier. So this dial here, this speaker out dial, allows me to run to that orange 2x12 or any given cab at either 16, 8 or 4 ohms, whatever we're running. We can even run two cabs at the same time if we want to from the Tube Amp Expander, which is a great thing because you can't normally do that from a single amplifier, or if you can't do that from a single amplifier, you can now with the Tube Amp Expander. And we can attenuate that down, so drop the volume without touching the response or feel of the amplifier. So that's the first thing that we can do with this, but unlike any other attenuator on the market, this particular attenuator allows you to tune the reactive load. Now you want a reactive load, without going too much into the science of this, you want a reactive load because this gives you a much more kind of natural response from your amplifier. Your amp sort of basically thinks it's seeing a standard speaker when it's plugged into the Waza Tube Amp Expander. So it really feels like you're playing through your amp through a standard speaker cab. And that's what you want. You don't want to touch the sound or feel or response of your amp. You just want to turn it down in the room whilst having the master volume cranked like this. That's what we need. However, this goes a lot further than that because we can tune the reactive load, the high end and low end response, using these two controls, the resonance and presence controls. So we'll do that as well. And that allows us to tune the characteristics of the high end and the low end in terms of the feel and the sound that we've got. And it's a really powerful shaping tool, essentially giving us, I think it's 16 different reactive loads within a single unit, which is again, totally a first on the market. It's incredible. So let's check that out first. As I say, any of the effects and stuff that you're going to be hearing are coming from the Tube Amp Expander. At the moment, we've got this. So there's some delay and stuff going on. Let me switch that off. So now we've got a little bit of reverb. I'll dial that down as well. Okay, now you're hearing the sound of our orange 2x12 mic'd up in the room. And again, the amp is fairly cranked. What I can do is I can take this speaker out and roll it down, and we're getting exactly the same sound coming out of the amplifier, exactly the same feel, but it's quieter. Now that's amazing, because that means that I can now have that, say, 2x12 in the room with me, and I'm not deafening myself, and I can record with the same feel and same tone with a mic'd setup, or I can play live with my amp absolutely cooking and not killing the guy in the front row. And it's just a great way of making a 100 watt or 50 watt head, for instance, applicable to a smaller environment or to a recording environment, which is absolutely amazing. However, as I say, that's been a product that's been around for years now. Where the Boss differs in one way is this reactive low tuning. So what I can do now is I can turn my cab back up again. And I can start to tune the response of the high end and the low end. So let's start with the high end. And you can hear the tube amp expander click as I move around. It moves between these different reactive loads. So I've set the presence all the way up now to high. Now therein lies some subtlety. It's not this kind of really kind of grand change that you're going to hear. It is very subtle, but it allows you to tune this to sound much more like a particular type of speaker, so a 1x12 or a 2x12 or a 4x12, and get the feel of your amp tuned in exactly right the way you want it to be. And actually, Boss have on the top of the Waza Tube Amp Expander labeled a bunch of different settings for various different cabs and various different types of amplifier, whether you're running a tweed or whether you're running a blackface Fender style amp or something crazy like this Super Kraken. They give you suggested sounds that you can actually tune your reactive load to. Now, if I play with the resonance control now, you can start to hear some of those subtle differences, and they are really, really translated well into the feel of the playing. Like, I particularly liked the resonance control and the low setting with this amp. It sounds really nice. It's got this throaty kind of sound, and the feel is really, really good. So that's the first thing that's different about this product, this tunable reactive load that allows you to really tailor the sound to really fit with your playing style and the amplifier and the cab that you're using at the time. So that's really, really cool. The other thing that's amazing about this unit is there is a power amp built into it. Now, let's say you're running a 5-watt amp. You really like the sound of this particular 5-watt combo or head that you've got, but it's not loud enough to compete with a drummer on a gig on stage or, you know, wherever you're using that amplifier. There's just not enough headroom. This actually, the power amp that's built into this allows you to plug that amp into this, the Waza Tube Amp Expander, and then use the power amp to make that amplifier louder. Now that's amazing, because you can take that fantastic sound that you get from a 5-watt amp cranked, all that lovely power tube saturation of a smaller kind of wattage head or combo, and make it gig volume, incredible, and run it into a larger cab, for instance. Absolutely amazing. It's such a versatile thing. That's why they call it the tube amp expander, because you can expand the versatility of your particular tube amp at any time. However, it goes even further than that, because not only have you got all of that amazing reactive load setting with all 16 different reactive loads, you also have an incredible effects section built in. You have an effects loop on there which can be run in series or parallel, and the absolute pièce de résistance is Boss have also included a fully fledged speaker simulation and very high-end I/O section that allows you to take a tube amp like this and not use a cab at all, but run direct to a recording device, a DAW, or to front of house using really high-quality speaker simulation, or any of 4 IRs of your own choosing that you can load into the device using the USB input or output from the device. And that USB section also allows you to run this as a fully fledged audio interface. So you could even run tracks through this. You can, you know, I've got it USB'd into my laptop here. I could run tracks through this. I could use it as a monitoring device. There's a headphone socket on there. You've got headphones dial on the front here. So it replaces so many different things. Your effects units, it replaces your audio interface. It's, again, an amazing I/O section on the back there. There's MIDI built into this as well. It's just incredible. So let's go through some of those features. Now, the first thing I want to talk about is the effects section. I've got it plugged into, as I say, my laptop here, and you get this lovely sort of graphic user interface here that you can utilize. Now we're screen capturing this, so you'll be able to see some of this as well. We can see the signal chain here. So we've got the signal coming in, and then we've got things like compressions, reverbs, delays, and there's an effects loop on there. I can switch that in and out as well. I've got a Boss MD500 placed fairly precariously on there. I hope it doesn't fall off. I can switch that in and out if I want to. So I'm using the foot switch that you can get for this, the GAFC, which is a standard kind of Boss foot switch. But you can do it all from the front panel. So I could switch the effects loop on here. And I can do that again from the foot switch here as well if I wanted to. Again, you can purchase that separately and makes the unit even more flexible, which is pretty insane. So I've got the effects loop on there. I've also got the effects. So I can turn on here. I've got the compression on. I can also turn the delay on. So if I double click there, that delay is now on. And I've got a ton of different delays here. So you can see I've got single, pan, stereo, analog, and the SDE3000, which truly gives you some incredible delays. And all of these delays have modulation built in. You can really start to tailor things like the high-end frequency response of those, you know, dial out the high-end if you want to. It's just an incredible thing. So with these delays on now, and of course, some of these are running in stereo as well because we're running out XLRs stereo using the speaker simulation. So if we could turn the DI on for the through the monitors in the room, we'll be able to I'll be able to hear the DI as well. So now we'll switch out the cab and you'll just be hearing the DI sound through the speaker emulation. And the speaker emulation that I'm running here with the effects on, I've got a 4x12 standard here. We'll get into that in a second. There is a lot to talk about here, guys. So the delays. Really nice sounding studio quality delays. Boss have really gone to town here. It just sounds so good. And again, remember there's nothing in the front end here. All the effects are coming out of the DI out. Now the amazing thing is, unlike a similar product on the market, and I'm not trying, I mean, it's important for the review to compare and contrast here. There's another product on the market that you guys will probably know that does a sort of similar job to this, made by Universal Audio. It's a fantastic product, but there is a big difference between these two in terms of the effects section, because the effects on this can be routed through either the line outs or stroke and the speaker outs. So you can use the effects on this through your cab and through the line outs, which again, is completely unique to this product. So that's a big plus point for the Waza Tube Amp Expander. So we've got the delays on there. And again, I can switch, let's say, to an analog delay here. So you can hear those are darker. They don't get in the way as much. Beautiful sounding delays. Let me switch the delay off a second. So we can click on there to do it. Move over to the reverb section. And we've got some classic reverbs, two halls, a plate, a room. Two rooms and a spring. So we'll stick with the hall. And actually the reverb can be controlled via the front panel as well. Not everything can, you can't control the delays, for instance. So if we turn the reverb up, you can see that global effect control for the reverb is being affected on the actual user interface. And now we've got this lovely long hall reverb. It sounds great. They're all studio quality effects. And again, we can switch between those and do whatever we want. There's a huge amount of tailoring on here. You can see we've got sort of high and low cuts, pre-delay, all the usual things you would find, but there's a lot of tweakability on here. And then we've also got a compressor. So I'm using the compressor at the moment. There's the rack compressor and the VTG compressor on there as well. So some really nice high-end compression and all the usual controls. We've got a ratio, threshold, so on and so forth. And again, any of these effects can be routed to any of the signal paths. You can see on the user interface here where they split off. We've got our speaker out and our line out here. And there is also a really fully fledged parametric or graphic EQ for either the speaker out or the line out. And then two global EQs as well. One for the speaker out and one for the line out. Really, really powerful tone shaping here. Now, the final thing to talk about really is the speaker simulation. This is really incredible as well because you've got a lot of flexibility here depending on what you're doing. So the speaker simulation, if I click on here, we're using a 4x12 standard. We've got a condenser mic here, the condenser 87. And then we've got the mic distance, the mic position, so where it is on the cone, how far off the cone it is. And then we've got a room mic as well. So we're using the big room mic here. There is an anechoic setting which basically removes any room mic, a small room and a big room. And then the various different mics. The only thing that's missing here, since this is a review, I have to say the negatives as well. For some reason, Boss have decided not to put a ribbon mic in there. and everybody wants to see a Royer R121 in there, and there's just not one there. So maybe in a future firmware update, as all these companies do these days, they might put a Royer in there. I hope they do. But you've got, you know, a couple of dynamic mics, a couple of condenser mics, and then a flat setting. And so if we play with a few of these, at the moment, again, you're hearing the 4x12 standard. And personally, I think these are really, really lovely, very realistic sounding and feeling cab simulations. If we go to the 4x12 rectifier, it's a darker sound. It's a great sound, and again, if we use that as an example, if we change the mic here to a 57, change the distance, so we'll go for short. When you're in short, medium, and long, basically you're getting less proximity effect the farther up your way, away from the cab you're moving, which basically is the low end thump, but you're also getting more room sound. So if I go, we're on the big room here. If I go further away, for instance, to the long setting, there's more of the room sound in there. Okay, so if I go for anechoic, which is no room sound at all. And then go back to big room. So again, fairly subtle differences, but they make a big difference to the feel and response of everything. Now, at the same time as we've got all of this functionality, we can always, even through the DI outs, go back to the variable reactive load and tune this to change the feel and response. So again, if I'm in this position, and I now tune the low end or the resonance control, then the high end, let's bring this down to low. So again, subtle differences, but for me playing, that really makes a difference to how the amp feels and reacts as I'm playing. So it's a really nice thing to have that tone shaping there as well. We've also got a solo EQ and boost on there as well. So if I turn that on, even more flexibility, and to top all of this off, you'll see this rig control here. Now this allows me to store any of these parameters for either the speaker out or the line out, or both together of course, into a rig, and I can store all of those settings into one of 10 different positions on here. And then I can also, using the software, write as many different rigs as I want, and that will store all of the delay, reverb, compression, speaker simulation, line out and speaker out EQ settings within a single rig that I can recall either using this, you can see here, everything updating as I'm moving between these different rigs, both on the software and of course on the unit itself, and of course on the foot switch, which I'm using down here. And again, I could recall any of those and share them with friends of mine or online, whatever, or with a producer, for instance, if they've got one in their studio, you know, utilizing the software and save as many presets as I want. It's just incredible. So there's a ton of flexibility there as well. And of course, to top all of this off again, it never ends. I can use the USB out to record all of this to my DAW and not even need an audio interface. So really, really incredible. It's just a phenomenal unit. Now, again, just to reiterate, I do have the floor unit down here, which gives me some extra operation, and I can switch rigs using the JFC. The other thing I can do, if I go back to rig one here, if I just switch back to our drive sound here, you can see that there I've actually done channel switching via the unit here, so I can actually switch channels on the Kraken here. There's my clean channel, and again I could do this via a foot switch. And I've got an expression pedal plugged into my foot switch down here. Now you could do this just via the back of the unit. You don't need the foot switch to do this, but I've got an expression pedal plugged in that's going to allow me to to basically use it as a volume control. So I can, so a ton of flexibility here. It really, you can see why they called it the Tube Amp Expander. It basically takes a tube amp, and it's a utility tool that basically makes it the most versatile device you could use for recording, live use, you know, whatever you're going to be doing. You take this incredible tone and you make it infinitely more flexible, and you could totally see how somebody could just own one of these, a really nice high-end tube amp and a Boss tube amp expander, and you wouldn't need anything else. Maybe a modulation pedal in the effects loop, and that would be it. All your delays, all your reverbs, all your cab simulations, all your mic simulations, an audio interface, a variable reactive load in there as well, all in one device. And it's pretty affordable considering all of those things. If you were to buy them separately, this represents a really good value for money proposition. So again, headphone out on there as well, so you can practice using your tube amp without, you know, using a speaker out just privately in a hotel room if you wanted to. It's phenomenal. Really well built as well. Works great. We'll show you a sweep of the back panel and stuff as well, so you can check that out. It's just a phenomenal device. Boss have already done a few firmware updates for it as well, so you know, hopefully as we go along, that ribbon mic will get introduced. But really, that's the only negative I can find with the whole product. It's just phenomenal. So there we have it, guys, the Boss Waza Tube Amp Expander. As usual, I hope you enjoyed this review. Check out the full text in the magazine for our full thoughts and the rating that we gave to this particular unit. And yeah, my name is Tom Quayle, and I will see you all in the next review. Bye-bye.